Hey, what's up everyone? In this video, I'll be showing you how to downgrade the firmware version on your Netgear Orbi router, as well as disable the automatic updates to prevent the router from updating the firmware automatically. So, to get started, pretty simple. Our first step is to downgrade the firmware, which is the most straightforward step or part of this video. Go to your router's page. By default, it's 192.168.1.1. Sign in. The default username is admin. The default password is password. No capitals, just admin and password. From there, go to advanced, go to administration, go to firmware update, and you'll see this page. Nope, you'll see online update. I'm just going to cancel that. By default, you'll see online update. Basically, it checks the Netgear servers for a new update, and then it asks you if you want to update. Obviously, we don't want to do that right now. You probably don't even have an update available, so we're going to go to manual update because we're going to not update but downgrade. So what you're going to need to do is go to Netgear's website and go to the support page. Easiest way to do this is to just Google Netgear Orbi and then whatever version you have. Find the version and then you'll come to the support page, click on downloads, and at the bottom this page will show up. You're going to want to click on more firmware. Or view previous versions. Click on that. Find the firmware version that you want. If you're coming from my video on how to separate the SSIDs for both 2.4 and 5 gigahertz, you're going to want to have firmware version 2.1.4.16. So right down here, as you can see, we have the Orbi satellite as well as the Orbi router. You're going to want to download both of these files because we're going to need to downgrade both router and satellite. If you only have one router, you don't have to worry about the other satellite. So let's go ahead and we'll download these. I'm not actually going to downgrade my routers because they're already at the version that I want them at. And then so basically we have them in our downloads folder. We can go and click browse over here, go to our downloads, and then we're gonna want to find we'll update our router first. I don't really think it matters too much whether you do the satellite first or the router first, but the router will always have the R in the name. So as you can see, RBR50, and then this is RBS50, RB router, RB satellite. Find whichever one. So we're going to do the router first. We're going to choose. It pops the file up right here. We can click upload, and then it will automatically update the or downgrade the Orbi router to that firmware. Now let's say we're going to do the satellite, find the satellite file, and then we're going to want to check this box to because we're going to update this and then click update here. So that'll take this file and apply it to this RBS50. So this is pretty straightforward. Just find the file, click upload or update, and then it will basically just do its thing and downgrade the firmware version to whichever version that you choose. So now here's the slightly more advanced version. You're going to want to have some type of Telnet client. So as you can see, I have Windows 10 open here and I have Telnet enabled. So if we go to, let's see if I can find it, turn Windows features on and off. We go down to Telnet. Oh, I do not have it enabled. So check that to enable it. It's completed and we're good to go. Now from here, we're going to want to go and open the command prompt. So just type in CMD if you're on Windows, and then you're going to need a Telnet client for Mac OS. I'm not sure of anyone that's built in. I'm sure there is somewhere somehow, but I don't know about it. I do know about Windows though. So open up the command prompt and we're going to have to enable Telnet on our router. So go back to here. We're going to want to go to 192.168.1.1/debug.htm. You might need to log in again. And you should only need to do this for the router. You don't have to do this for the satellite. And then go ahead and choose Enable Telnet. It'll go and refresh the page, and that's it. We're good to go here. So now going over to our command prompt. We're going to type in telnet 192.168.1.1, basically whatever your router's IP address is. Default again 192.168.1.1. go ahead and log in the same way that you would log in if you were to visit your router's web page. So admin, password. Okay, so once you log in, you'll see this page. It says OSDK, I believe. That means that I'm on the firmware version 2.1.4.16. If you're on a newer version, it says something different. I'm not too sure what it says, but I feel like they've changed that at some point. I don't know why. But now we can go ahead and start typing stuff. So the first thing that we want to type is nvram space show. And we're going to do that little separator sign. It's right below the backspace key, right above the enter key. You do need to press the shift bar to choose that. And then space grepauto underscore asterisk. So there it is, nvram show grep auto, whatever that means. Press enter, and then this will come up. Now this is just a bunch of kind of basic settings for how your router will act. And so there's three in particular that we want that really stand out for us. Orbi auto update, you can see a big number right there. We also have auto check for upgrade, as well as auto update. So now we're gonna need to change all three of those values. Now, how are we gonna do this? Start by typing nvram set, and then we're gonna go through each of those three lines that we pointed out. So orbi underscore auto underscore upgrade equals, and we want to set this value to 0. So go ahead and choose that. So we did that. Now we're gonna wanna do that for the others. So we'll do nvram set auto check for upgrade equals 0. All right, I typed that wrong. Type it in correctly and you should not have a problem. All right, we're good there. And then one more, nvram, almost made the same mistake, set auto update equals 0. All right, so now to check this, basically we can just type in the same thing that we did earlier to bring up that whole list. So type in nvram show that little wall grep auto underscore asterisk. And then if you wait a few minutes, the auto upgrade, Orbi auto upgrade, this one up here might change to a different number. That's fine though, because it's just basically like a counter of how much time has gone by since it's checked or something like that. I'm not too sure, but that one will change eventually. Don't worry about it. But as long as the other two do not change, then you're good to go. So as you can see down here, auto check for upgrade equals 0, auto update equals 0. That means we're good to go. It will not update. But now we still have one more step, and it's probably the most important step. Make sure you don't miss it. We need to do nvram commit. Go ahead and type that, press enter. I'm not gonna do that because I already changed the values already. I'm not gonna oversave or rewrite anything. I don't wanna cause any issues because it's very touchy, and I'd rather not have to deal with that. But once you do that, once you do nvram commit, you save it, everything's good to go. You're basically all set. Your router will not update automatically. You can stay at whatever version that you want to stay at. You can manually update the firmware whenever you want. You don't have to, you know, get interrupted because your router wants to update on its own. It can be super annoying. And, you know, if you're on a stable version that you really like, why not just stick with it? Anyway, that's it for this video. If you want to learn how to separate your SSIDs, have like a separate 2.4 and 5 gigahertz band network so that you can manually choose between them, go ahead and check out my video. I'll have a link in the description. Make sure you follow this step first so your router's on version 2.1.14.10 or something. I don't remember what it was, but the version that I have is, to me, the most stable, and you can separate the SSIDs, which is pretty cool. Anyway, that's it for this video. Thanks for watching. If you have any questions, leave them down below. Also, my email address is in the description. If you have any questions, go ahead and shoot me an email. Thanks for watching again, and I'll see you in the next one.